Solve tangent squared x minus 1 equals 0 on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, close on 0, open on 2 pi, then give an expression for all of the solutions, use k as any integer. To solve the equation, we can either add 1 to both sides and then take the square root of both sides of the equation, or we can factor tangent squared x minus 1 as a difference of squares. So beginning with the given equation, we have tangent squared x minus 1 equals 0. I'm going to go ahead and factor the left side as a difference of squares. Tangent squared x minus 1 is equal to the quantity tangent x minus 1 times the quantity tangent x plus 1. From here, the left side is equal to 0 when tangent x minus 1 equals 0, or when tangent x plus 1 equals 0. And now we need to solve both of these equations for tangent x. For the first equation on the left, we add 1 to both sides, which gives us tangent x equals 1. For the second equation, we subtract 1 on both sides, which gives us tangent x equals negative 1. For the first part of the question, we now need to find all the angles in the given interval that have a tangent function value of 1 or negative 1. Having a tangent function value of positive 1 should remind us of a 45, 45, 90 reference triangle shown here, or a pi divided by 4, pi divided by 4 reference angle, where notice the tangent of pi divided by 4 equals the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side, or 1 divided by 1, which equals 1. Also remember, on the coordinate plane, tangent theta equals y divided by x, which indicates tangent is positive in the first and third quadrants and negative in the second and fourth quadrants. This indicates we have to find the angle in the first and third quadrants where the tangent function value is positive 1, and the angles in the second and fourth quadrants where the tangent function value is negative 1. All these angles will have a reference angle of pi divided by 4 radians. So now we'll go ahead and sketch a reference angle of pi divided by 4 in each of the four quadrants. Now that we have the reference angles in each quadrant, let's go ahead and sketch the corresponding reference triangles. And now let's go ahead and label the sides of the reference triangles in each quadrant. We know in the first quadrant, both x and y are positive, and therefore we label both legs positive 1, hypotenuse square root 2. In the second quadrant, x is negative and y is positive, and therefore this leg is negative 1, this leg is positive 1, hypotenuse is square root 2. In the third quadrant, both x and y are negative, which indicates both legs are negative 1, hypotenuse is square root 2. And in the fourth quadrant, x is positive, y is negative, this leg is negative 1, hypotenuse is square root 2. Notice in the first and third quadrants, the tangent function value is positive 1. In the second and fourth quadrants, the tangent function value is negative 1. And now let's determine the angles in the given interval. Of course, in the first quadrant, we have pi divided by 4, which is our first solution in the given interval. If you have a difficult time determining the remaining angles, we can always count by pi divided by 4, or 1/4 pi radians. Starting at the positive x-axis, we have 1/4 pi, 2/4 pi, 3/4 pi radians, or 3 pi divided by 4. Starting at 3/4 pi radians, we have 4/4 pi, 5/4 pi radians for the next solution, or 5 pi divided by 4. And finally, for the last solution over the given interval, we have 5/4 pi, 6/4 pi, 7/4 pi radians, or 7 pi divided by 4 radians. These are the four solutions on the given interval from 0 to 2 pi, closed on 0, open on 2 pi. And now let's work on an expression for all solutions. To do this, we can start at any of the solutions. Let's start at x equals pi divided by 4. Notice if we start here, we'd have to add 1/4 pi, 2/4 pi, or pi divided by 2 to get the next solution, and that pattern continues. 1/4 pi, 2/4 pi, we have to add another pi divided by 2 to get the next solution, and so on. Which means we can start at any solution and add multiples of pi divided by 2 to get all of the solutions. We could express this as x equals pi divided by 4 plus multiples of 2 pi, which would be plus pi divided by 2 times k, where k is any integer. This would be all solutions. I hope you found this helpful.